and welcome to another episode of the DA100 Certification Series. This is episode 2, and in this episode, we are looking at prepare the data, 20 to 25% of the exam questions, and we're specifically looking at the get data from different data sources, focused in on the following two items: select a shared data set or create a local data set, and selecting a storage mode. Let's get started by looking at what a shared data set is. When we create our first report, we upload that to Power BI service, and then we make the data set that housed within inside that report available to other Power BI users that have access to that workspace. Let's go and look at share the data set documentation. And here we can see that the data sets that we have available can be also leveraged. So we're going to do a quick examination of that. We're going to open up an existing report. And here's the Dashboard in the Day report that we created as part of the Dashboard in the Day workshop. We have uploaded and published that report to the Power BI service. Inside of this, we have 5 object states: geography, manufacturer, product, and sales as different tables inside of that. And the relationships that are existing within inside that model are shown here, with manufacturer and product filtering down into sales, and also date and geography performing a one-to-many filter as well. We're going to look at creating a brand new Power BI report and importing the Power BI data set. So we're going to go to File and then New, and we'll wait for that empty file to open up. Once that's opened up, we will be able to then go to Get Data and choose the Get Power BI data set. So we're just waiting for this to initialize the empty model. Once that's loaded, we're able to go and leverage all of the existing tables and queries and transformations that have been created for that data set. So we go to Get Data here, click on Power BI data set, which is the second one in this list at the moment. And notice there's also Power BI data flows below that, but we're not covering those today. We click on Power BI data sets. This will then look at the authentication I have and give me a list of all of the workspaces that I have access to. I'm going to perform a filter to filter down the Dashboard in the Day report that I'm looking for. And here, if I click the Dashboard in the Day report, the Create button at the bottom of the screen will then be highlighted. I can click on Create, and this is going to then allow me to access that existing Power BI data set. So we'll be able to see on the right hand side now all of those different tables that exist. Now, if I look on the left hand side, you'll notice that our data pane has now disappeared. We have a report pane and we have our model pane. But because we've come into a Power BI data set, we don't have the ability to access the data pane. The reason being, we won't have access to other data to bring in. We can't merge it with other data sets. We're just making use of essentially calls to that existing data set. So if that data set's evolved and has additional tables and capabilities put into it, then we will be able to reflect those inside this report. But we can't amend and add that data set at this point. To the model, you can see that we do have those entries. I was going to rearrange them roughly to the way they were before, just so you can kind of see that we have the similar kind of structure here. And I'll bring this one down a little bit. And you see that we still have the 5 tables with the relationships as per the original data set. So that is the shared data set. Now let's look at a local data set, which is predominantly what you would do when you first start using Power BI, and most of the time when you bring data in. We're going to start with, again, a new file. So File, New, an empty file. And in this case, I'm just going to go and grab one of the Excel files I have from one of the tutorials and bring that data in, and then show you some information about that model and compare that to this model here. So we're just going to wait for that to load. So we have a new empty Power BI report again. Once more, we're going to go to Get Data. This time we do have all of the capabilities. So from visualization to data to modeling, I'm going to choose Excel. I'm just going to choose one of the existing Excel files and click open. I'm going to load that directly inside our Power BI without any transformations, just a quick load, because we don't want to focus on Power Query errors today. So I'm going to check that box, click load, and this is loading the data into the Power BI model. So this is a local data set. We've loaded it directly into the in-memory data set, as opposed to having a shared data set, which is external to the Power BI model, but it's essentially a link to that workspace to be able to access that data. So again, we have one table. In this case, we've got all of the files and kind of that would represent that specific data set. In this case, it's a single file, and here's the columns and data structures in that. If I go to my field pane, you'll see that we do have that one table. I'm just gonna open that up a little bit further. Now, if I highlight that table, there's a property panes that opens up on the right-hand side. And in here, if I go to the advanced tab, notice that we do now have the storage mode option and drop down. Now, it's the only one available right now because of what we've imported. If I created maybe a direct query, SQL Server, for example, we'd be able to look at kind of maybe having this a direct query import as well. So we've got options there, either sending the query to the SQL Server and getting it back as a result, or importing the data one time and then refreshing that. So do we want to get the data local, or do we want to do a direct query? These are the options in terms of the storage mode. There is a dual option, which is a hybrid of those two. So you may have some cache data, maybe the last couple of months worth of data, but anything beyond that could be a direct query. So we've got options around direct queries and import. There are some limitations to these different modes. You need to go and refer to the documentation for all of the details around those. And that is the difference between a shared data set, which is held in the service, a local data set, which is imported into Power BI. And we also have a storage mode of direct query or import. That's it for this episode. We will see you in the next episode, and good luck with your training.